Living in the 21st century is quite exciting, really. And in the age of rapid development and climate change, humanity is probably approaching a new chapter in its adventurous path called space exploration. There are plenty of planets worth our attention, potential new worlds with endless possibilities. But to get there, we need to start somewhere. The Moon is our closest neighbor, and we've even been there before. And right now, we're just a few years away from visiting it again. NASA is planning the Artemis 3 mission, aiming at sending humans to the Moon again, but this time, not just to visit. This time, we will be trying to implement permanent human presence on the Moon, and we are actually very determined to do so. Why is this so important? Is it economically feasible? And what are we actually going to be doing there? The Moon is our closest space neighbor, and a crucial player in our interplanetary development. Comparing modern life challenges to, let's say, the Middle Ages, space for us now is like the Atlantic Ocean for humans back then, and the Moon for us now is like this great island, where we could find these new and weird animals, corn, tomatoes, and potatoes, for example. Well, the Moon is not so welcoming. With its 120 degrees Celsius during the day, and minus 130 during the night, and its lack of atmosphere, and its 6 times weaker gravity, and its devastating radiation, etc., etc. We will not find any food there, and we will most definitely not find coyotes and badgers either. What we will find, though, is enormous advantages for humanity nowadays, and tools with which we could shape our new future. Many astronomers consider the far side of the lunar surface to be the best place to build a strong radio telescope. Unlike Earth, which has a strong magnetic field and atmosphere that distorts a lot of the captured signals and pictures, the Moon has none of that. Sheltering itself from Earth's hum, the far side of the Moon hides great potential in revealing the true nature and scale of our galaxy, and maybe it will eventually lead us to our new home. Have you ever noticed that airports are always at the edge of, or even outside, cities? It makes sense, right? You need a lot of free space, equipped, managed, and highly restricted areas, passenger control, and security. It would be so inconvenient and dangerous to do this at the center of a city. It's the same with our Earth. To invest in space exploration, we need development of new technologies, space for optimization or a testing ground, and a lot of energy. Even the close universe is really big, and obstacles are everywhere. Earth's gravity is about 6 times stronger than the gravity of the Moon, which makes it significantly harder to send a rocket in space due to the amount of energy needed. Or said differently, diving in space from the Moon's surface will allow us to send 6 times more massive crafts compared to sending them from the Earth. Not only that, Earth's atmosphere makes it even harder to escape its prison, a problem that does not exist on the Moon. Previous missions have even found frozen water on the Moon, which we can easily split into oxygen to use as breathing air for our future crew members, and hydrogen to use as a powerful fuel. All in all, the Moon hides great potential to serve as an airport, as a station from which we could expand beyond our imagination. Humans could also use the Moon as an excellent mining spot. Our sweet home, Earth, is not just a rock floating in space. It's a living organism running chemical processes within itself. Its ecosystem produces valuable substances for our survival. So mining Earth to get our precious materials is kind of suicidal. It might be wiser to export as much mining as possible and as soon as possible. The Moon, being a great place to start, seems to contain significant amounts of helium-3, for example, which can be used as a fuel in future nuclear fusion power plants. Iron and titanium are other valuable resources we could extract from the lunar surface. The Clementine spacecraft, which was launched in January 1994, detected high levels of those metals around the lunar mare, dark regions created by ancient lava flows. And it gets even better. These ores are actually oxides, which means they will produce oxygen as a byproduct. Energy is arguably the most important resource for an advanced civilization. Humans are strongly dependent on it, and how we manage to gain it is crucial for our survival as a species. With the helium-3 we have extracted from the lunar surface, we can fuel plenty of nuclear fusion power plants. But that's scary, right? Not if we build those plants on the Moon as well. The Moon is also very appropriate for making solar collectors. Yes, its surface is 6 times less than Earth's, but it has no oceans. So in terms of surface area, which can be used for solar collectors, the Moon is even larger compared to Earth. It is also much better suited for it, as it has no atmosphere to block a large portion of the spectrum. With energy production, the Moon can close the cycle as an important station, a large industrial zone to be used by humans for science, exploration, travel, and our own development as an interplanetary species.